Ladies and gentlemen, opening the gates of our soul. It is a beautiful image, and I'm deeply honored and touched to be here with Ani Choying Drolma, who's for the first time in Romania. And I think this is a beautiful opportunity to regain our image of what's mean real education, what's mean compassion, what's mean love, what's mean giving, and we are hardly needing all those kind of feelings, ideas, and action. Ani Choying Drolma represents what we are looking for forward, represents for me a model. And we're going to have 60 minutes to see and to look in our souls with Ani Choying Drolma. Thank you for being here, and I'm deeply touched. It is a dream for me to be here with you those 60 minutes. And I know that you accept to pray here for the world, for us. Thank you. is very touching. I'm wordless after you are singing.
Thank you.
What does you are saying in this song, in this prayer?
This was an invocation song of a Buddha Bodhisattva who is able to, is an invocation song to him. Who we consider him as a very powerful, compassionate being to dispel all the negative energy away. Negative emotions, negative energy, negative thoughts, everything in people and around people.
Yes, and, we have to learn from Guru Rinpoche, from all the Buddhas, that we can live our life in the beautiful emotions, such as love and compassion.
Well, emotion with the absence of negativity is the best emotion.
Mm-hmm. What is the root of negativity in our lives?
Ignorance.
Ignorance.
Yeah, ignorance and driven emotion, negative emotions such as greed, attachment, arrogance, driven by ignorance. Is what is causing everything, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I want to ask you about, you are an international renowned singer now. Mm-hmm. And how does it happen? It was back in 1998, mm-hmm. I read. And you expected your life to become like this?
No, not at all. Oh. I had no plan at all to be known as a singer, actually. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, people still, consider me as a singer, but I'm a practitioner. Mm-hmm. When I sing, I just use melody just as a method only. But main ingredient in mm-hmm. this experience is the meditation.
The meditation, you are not singing, you are praying, you are meditating.
I'm meditating.
I'm meditating.
Along with the spiritual songs.
Songs, yes. I was looking on YouTube on a clip with you in a concert hall with thousands of people. Mm-hmm. And you were simply walking, mm-hmm. and like here. It was mm-hmm. amazing. This is the original attitude of all musicians, I think. To meditate, mm-hmm. not to sing, and this I think is already lost in our
pure state of mind. I would say
mm-hmm. a pure state of mind.
Yeah.
Yes. and you are in fact not a professional singer.
So-called professional.
Yeah. Because what you are singing, meditating. For the children, for the elder, for a project, mm-hmm. can you tell us something?
Well, while I sing, I don't think about anything of those things.
Oh.
So, yeah. It's pure meditation. Of course, the aspiration is to be able to bring benefit to all beings, you know, because mm-hmm. as a human being, we all wish for happiness in life. No one of us wishes for suffering. That is the basic foundation of the common desire we all share. Mm-hmm. So, and then the practice for myself to be free from suffering, it comes as a meditation together with this spiritual singing. But then the singing outcome of this technical singing at the end becomes a resource mm-hmm. That helps me to fulfill the needs of some of the project that I am very much mm-hmm. Engaged in Nepal. And that is, of course, to be able to see all the girls, women in Nepal to be get proper education, academic education.
Proper academic education.
Education plus, of course, the spiritual education nowadays is very, very important, I strongly believe. So that is my aspiration. And then not only education, but a basic medical facility also is very, very important for everyone to enjoy.
So you are the founder of Nuns Welfare Foundation of Nepal.
Yeah, that's a small organization that I established in mm-hmm. the government. It's a non-governmental organization. Mm-hmm. So that I can do things more legally.
More legally.
Yeah.
You're talking about medical projects. So is it the first kidney hospital from Nepal that mm-hmm. that you're...
it's a project for kidney hospital, but then this hospital project has been able to establish the first HLA lab in Nepal, which never existed before. And now we've been very successfully, I would say, been able to convince the government also to bring the policy to make dialysis free for poor people. That was one of my very strong aspirations to establish in Nepal, to see in Nepal that my brothers and sisters in Nepal don't really have to suffer because of not having enough financial resources. So up to a certain level, I have been very successful, I should say, in fulfilling my aspiration. And there are many more things to do, of course. Yeah. It's human nature. The more we get, the more we want. So
you give us a lot, uh-huh. You get a lot, and you share a lot.
Well, that's how things work, I think. The universe works.
Yes.
What goes around comes around.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And also a hospital for animals.
Yeah, there are a few projects that are actually started by other people, mm-hmm. for animals, which I support. Mm-hmm. Because I wanted to do this project, but as I have only two hands and one human body, they're limited time, so I could not do it myself. But then when I saw somebody else is doing this project, I deeply rejoiced and I was really happy about this. Mm-hmm. So a little bit of money that I always try to continue to give to them to... Mm-hmm. to make their function more smoothly.
Mm. You have only two hands, but I saw 1,000 hands like Avalokiteshvara. Yeah.
That would be so nice, yes. Yeah. That's why I pray so much to Avalokiteshvara to be able to, you know, grow more 1,000 hands like Avalokiteshvara. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but then aspiration is definitely as big as having 1,000 arms. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's beautiful. Mm. Yes, let me now, Annie Choying, to offer you from the biggest university in Romania.
Wow.
The biggest private university in Romania. Mm-hmm. A diploma for great humanitarian and charitable activities. This diploma is also signed by some professional psychological association. Mm-hmm. And let me tell that it's signed by Counseling and Psychoanalytical Psychotherapy Association from Bucharest, the Center of Counseling and Career Orientation, also signed by the Romanian National Council of Disability, also by National Association for Children and Adults with Autism of Romania, and signed by Romanian Association for Transpersonal Psychology. It is a great honor to offer you this
thank
diploma.
Thank you so much.
Yes,
thank you.
I thank you.
This
and
is
it is a little sign of your work and your activity. And this is how Romanian people are looking to you and to you, to what you are beautiful doing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
With a deep gratitude, I would definitely accept this and also take this as a bigger responsibility to carry on further.
It is beautiful.
Yes.
A bigger responsibility.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you
very much. Well.
Yes, the education, this is the core of education.
Mm-hmm.
What you are saying and your attitude, this the compassionate attitude. How do you learn this attitude? You are radiating peace.
I don't think this is something external we try to get it into us, but it's already innate. It's a human innate nature.
Oh.
You see, even to think, though I'm not academically well-knowledged person, I would consider not like that, but somehow, even if you think carefully with your simple common sense, mm-hmm. we human being, you know, biologically are something that cannot live without kindness and care. Imagine when you were born, if your mother would not have nurtured you with her kindness and care, you probably would not survive. Even later on when you grow up, you continuously need the human care and nurturing, the love and the kindness to really nurture you and to grow you in a proper way. Mm-hmm. So this is something very, very innate nature that human being is existing with. It's all about, you know, enhancing that more. I mean, like, enhancing the power of that quality in you more and more, which helps not only yourself to be a happier human being or a more satisfied human being, but you will be able to reflect that energy on others. I believe that gives them an encouragement and a strength to believe in the human quality, good human quality. And that when it inspires them, then they also tries to enhance that quality in themselves. So when that is enhanced, then one by one, then more, as it is said, one can move a mountain, 100 can move a, you know, one can move a rock, 100 can move a mountain. So, yeah.
So together we can move the mountains, and absolutely, the mountain will listen to us.
Yes, human beings are the most powerful being on the earth, I think, most powerful, most intelligent being on earth. So we have so much power in us to be, of course, as constructive as possible and destructive as possible equally.
You have the chance to become a nun, and you decide to do this from a young age, and you have the chance to have a remarkable teacher, a master.
Yes.
Can you share with us something about this encounter, third degree encounter in your destiny?
Yeah, I mean, as I said earlier, every human being wish for happiness in life, and doesn't wish for suffering at all. And similarly, me too, even though I was a very young girl, at young age, I did not wish to suffer. But I was in a certain atmosphere where a lot of pain was experienced, and I did not want that one. So I tried to look for an alternative, alternative to, you know, choice. And that time, only alternative choice that I found in my life was to become a nun. Because the whole atmosphere was giving me a fear on a subject of being married. Because I thought, if a woman has to get married, means has to suffer in life. Somehow that that image in the society of married women, or because it's a male-dominated society we belong to. So somehow injustice, a little discrimination, unfairness was kind of strongly experienced myself. So I thought, okay, the best way to never get married, then I never have to, you know, experience those unpleasant discrimination. So that was one of the main reasons. But then, of course, I must have done so many good deeds in my past life, which as a Buddhist, we strongly believe in that. Consequence of that good deeds, I guess, I had a chance to meet this great teacher in my life, you know, who really helped me out to be able to transform myself from a very unhappy, angry girl towards a happier and more matured understanding, positively understanding being. So I always tell people that whatever little bit of a positivity that people are able to enjoy about me, in whether that is in my singing, or being myself, or mean in my activities, it's all because of his blessing. You know, without him, I doubt if I would have exhibited any of these qualities to the world. I doubt.
He trusted you, he loved you. There are the proper words for what he gave you. So
he gave me the right brought up, right education, and right he helped me to see things more correctly. Mm-hmm.
So to see that even the bad things generate good things.
Yes.
This is a mystery for the European mind.
See, it all depends on how we learn to perceive things in our life at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Even out of difficulties, you get a lesson. Mm-hmm. Instead of sobbing or crying over the pain, but why not learn from the pain? You know?
To learn from the pain?
Yeah, learn from the difficult situation. Because when you are in a situation which you don't like, you obviously want to be free from that situation. So you look for a solution. Then there's a lesson that you learn. Yeah? Then you are better prepared for the next. And then when you learn it, you take it as a lesson, then the pain itself will never be painful for you to suffer. Because it's a lesson.
And we usually do not consider the pain to be a lesson, but instead we are getting more angry and we are not accepting.
You take it as a punishment.
A punishment, yes. Yeah. We are in a culture of punishment in a way. This is a great art of seeing, good seeing thing.
See, in Buddhism, the definition of suffering and pleasure is all very simple. Whatever you are able to accept, you know, in your life, that is happiness. Whatever you are not able to accept, you resist in your life, is suffering.
This is a remarkable definition.
Yeah, this is very simple.
Very simple.
So once you are able to learn how to accept things. But of course, I mean, there are certain things you have to learn how to accept in the right way, not in the wrong way. Mm-hmm. You know? It's human mind. It's like example of in a chili. Mm-hmm. Chili is very hot and sharp. Mm-hmm. That's the nature of the chili. It's not the fault of the chili. Mm-hmm. But then when we, as a human being, some of us, chili is the most delicious spice and makes us enjoy the whole meal so much. Mm-hmm. But for some people, it's a suffering. Mm-hmm. It's a torture because he's not able to accept it, the taste of the chili. Mm-hmm. So it's human mind. For example, some people want to be healthy. They go to a gym. They pay a lot of money. And they work hard. They run for 10 kilometers and after 10 kilometers of run, they feel happy that they are able to run for 10 kilometers. But if somebody else make them run for 10 kilometers, they will take it as a punishment. So it's in the mind. If you take it as a punishment, then you suffer. If you take it as a exercise, then you enjoy. But you do the same thing. But being able to accept it or not accept it is making the difference.
We may accept all the things, all the events in our life, but still and yet I think it is difficult to accept it. And how can we learn to accept this, accept, not to resist?
See, there are certain things that has control, you have the control to make a difference. For instance, in the night time, the nature works in a way that it's dark. You cannot do anything about it. The whole universe, the nature functions its own way. But then there you have a power of switching on a light. You don't want darkness, you either light a candle or you light a bulb. That is in your control. You make your choice. You create your own comfort zone by within your capacity of your intelligence, wisdom, or your knowledge. You know, use those. Your common sense at the very simple level. I think you don't have to be a professor to be able to understand simple. Use simple common sense. So the most simple common sense, if we human being able to use, mm-hmm. we know that fire is burning, it's mm-hmm. hot, it mm-hmm. burns. Mm-hmm. Oh, you will use your intelligence to make proper use of the fire. Someone who doesn't have the knowledge of the fire, mm-hmm. it burns. Mm-hmm. Who doesn't have the wisdom or knowledge to use it, who's able to not to use the intelligence to make use of the fire, mm-hmm. then it mm-hmm. destroys you. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So similar, I think. Mm-hmm. I think it's not so complicated, I think, at yes. times. In fact, I remember mm-hmm. one incident. Once in Belgium, a friend of mine, his son, we were discussing, and he's not really a Buddhist, and he said, "Oh, Ani, it's so complicated to understand human being." Yeah. And that's what a lot of us, we think like that. Mm-hmm. But then I said, "No, I think it's most easy to understand human being. The most important basic foundation we share is that you wish to be happy as equally I wish to be happy. Mm-hmm. You wish to be respected as equally I wish to be respected. You wish to be loved equally as I wish to be loved in life. Mm-hmm. You wish to be comfortable in life as much as I do in my life." Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. But then the difference is there, how you want to be happy in life. Mm-hmm. How you try to achieve that happiness or that comfort or that respect mm-hmm. in your life. Mm-hmm. That makes the difference. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's so easy to, simple thing to understand. If I know that I love to be respected, and I know that you love to be respected, then I give you what you want. Mm-hmm. And then it is natural thing to come back, same respect. It's very easy to understand. But complication starts when the intention of that person's, the technique they use in achieving their interpretation of happiness or comfort mm-hmm. Or respect.
Mm-hmm. It is so simple, in fact. And when we discuss our decorations here, you choose simple things, yeah. a flower and some light, and yeah. that's all. Because in the West, we are used with complications, and our mind is always busy of thoughts, and we have to learn to meditate.
Mm-hmm. I totally agree with you that meditation is something very, very, very helpful in human life. Especially, of course, as we all wish to be happy, as I said, in order to experience that happiness. Mm-hmm. Very important to be able to establish a calm mind. The calmness mm-hmm. of mind is going to help you to develop the clarity of your mind. Mm-hmm. The clarity of your mind will help you to develop wisdom. Development of more wisdom in yourself will help you not to make any mistakes. A mistake is interpreted as a mistake when you experience something what you don't want. mm-hmm. The outcome of your action, if it is something what you don't want, then mm-hmm. it's a mistake. Mm-hmm. Then you will not do any mistake. No mistakes means life is good.
so simple.
It's yes. I think it's very
only simple. Only to know when and where we yes. do mistakes. The clarity of mind and the meditation. How can we meditate? What's meditation for you now?
To be able to focus your mind. I mean, let's say right now you think 10 things in your mind. Mm-hmm. Mind is too engaged. Mm-hmm. When a water you stir too much in a pond, mm-hmm. stir too much, mm-hmm. then it becomes very muddy. Mm-hmm. When you let it down, all the mud goes down, then you see mm-hmm. things clear. Water mm-hmm. is clear. Mm-hmm. So similarly, mind, if it is too many things in your mind, Especially if it is driven by your greed and arrogance and these negative emotions, which is, of course, has the power to drive you around because of your ignorance, then you are never calm. You are always like this. But if you focus your mind in one thing with the clarity, being aware itself is another way of meditating also. There are many techniques of meditation, many stages of meditation as well. And to have a good teacher really to guide you in life, in your meditation practice, is a very, very important thing. Yeah. If a wrong teacher guides you, then it's like a blind leading another blind. Then you will end up in holes or fall somewhere. Yeah.
Yes, we are blind people leads by other blinds usually in our Western societies.
Well, I feel that there are many intelligent and highly wisdom beings also in the West, I believe, you know. You see, it's not that these being doesn't exist in certain places and only exist in certain place. That's also a wrong concept, I believe.
Yeah. So we have near us a guide. If we wish to meet that guide, we can find.
Yeah.
And here I meet you, and you are a guide, and maybe if you accept to have another moment of meditation with your songs right now.
Yeah.
Yes. What is the message of
this song?
Yes.
Song. This is very simple but very profound, and this conceptual resource of this song is from Buddha's teaching, as it says. In the eyes of a flower, the world appears as flower. In the eyes of a thorn, the world appears as thorn. Reflection takes place according to the shape of the object. So what it is trying to say is that how everything depends on how we learn to perceive things in our life. Positively perceived, positive effect. Negatively perceived, negative effect. And according to our understanding capacity, which you and I might have little difference, you know, the judgment takes place. Most beautiful part of this song says, may my heart always be pure. May my words or speech always be word of wisdom. May the sole of my feet never kill an insect. In a beautiful eyes, the world always appears as beautiful. May I see the brightness of moon in the darkness of night. May I listen to the music of life, even in the driest leaves. Imagine a dry leaves are blown away by wind. There is also music in it. But the essence of the interpretation of the song is that even in the difficulties of life, struggle of life, there's a profound lesson to be learned. Or with a great joy, you can do it. So in a pure heart, the world always appears as beautiful. I mean, as pure. So this is what the song says.
Thank you. It's a beautiful.
So I hope you, everyone will be able to.
The world, it's our mirror.
Enjoy.
फूल को आँख में
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, it is. To meditate is a kind of discussion stopper. So it is difficult to make an interview and meditate in the same time.
Mm-hmm.
I would prefer to make a wordless interview with you.
Sorry?
A wordless, a speechless
interview.
Okay. Yes.
All right.
Yeah, with this look into your eyes, uh-huh, and with these beautiful emotions and feelings.
Yeah, silence is very, very important. Mm-hmm. Once in a while, silence is the most beautiful music you can really listen to.
Mm-hmm.
You can listen to yourself. Be in yourself. the silence, when I talk about silence, is not necessarily silence about outer silence, the inner silence. Yeah. When you are able to enjoy that inner silence, the most beautiful music you can really enjoy, and better than spa. So, yeah, be aware of your breath, yourself. Be in yourself, the natural state of mind. See if you can try to be in that moment. It is not necessary for you to be in it for a very long time, because you are not habitualized for that. We have not been able to develop that habit yet. So it takes time. So you do a little bit. Then you get back. Then again. You remind yourself again and again. And then everything is about habit. Once you have the habit, you don't really have to think about it. So it's like learning how to drive. At the very beginning, you're nervous about the driving, being in the car. You're afraid that you might end up pressing the wrong thing and end up an accident. It can hurt yourself, it can hurt others. You're afraid of those fear. You're filled with those fear, many things in your mind. Then slowly you, but your determination is clear that you have to learn how to drive. Then you take time, slowly you practice. Then you learn about how things functions. And then you come to a stage of practice where you are able to harmonize all those, you know, balance all those things. And there is a time comes when you are able to drive very comfortably and sing along while you're driving, or listen to music, or even you're talking over the phone while you're driving, which is not so healthy. But then you are more confident. You build up that habit. So it's all about habit.
It's about habit.
Yeah.
I'm looking to you and listening to you here in the studio, and we are in the television studio, all of lights, and hundreds of people looking at us. And you are equal to yourself as if you are alone. I feel this. So this is amazing. So usually, I have to be good. I have to make a good show and something. This is stressing, and this is not being ourselves.
I think the world is coming back to a very true nature. Everything people want organic, natural, true,
and you know? Simple.
Simple. Yeah. But it takes time. So it takes time for people to take off the mask and be comfortable with yourself.
You have no mask.
I'm not comfortable with the mask. With the mask, I feel lost.
The core of education process is to be able to renounce of your masks. This is
forget about renouncing. Don't put any
don't
mask.
Put
at
a, the,
you,
no.
you are already yourself. You don't need a mask. So.
Yes, the mask, the education, and in is the state education a good education for our days, or this kind of schools, institutionalized schools, are in the risk to give us a mask.
Because it is so much giving pressure to develop the head. Not the heart. If you develop too much of a head, then you become like a machine. But you're a human being. So to be a human being, you need both connection to heart and head. Intellectual development is also important, but it is very important to focus on spiritual development also. If this two does not connect, and balance creates a harmony, a balance in everything you do, you think, you say, then there's some disbalance in the consequence of your actions, your thoughts, your speech will create some imbalance, consequence, I guess. So I think it's very important nowadays to be able to think of education that is not only necessary for the head, but for the heart.
For the heart.
Yes.
In Arya Tara school, you have thought of thinking and project that those kind of education to be joined.
Yes. That is one of the main focus of my school. Mm-hmm. Heart and head.
Heart and head. Heart and head, no head and heart.
Yeah.
This is the order.
Yeah.
The heart education.
Well, if these two are in good good terms, then it is good. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult. Mm-hmm. You see, even those people who creates a lot of bombs or kills a lot of people, or let's say who blew away Twin Tower. You don't think they are educated? They are educated. Mm-hmm. But then not spiritually.
Mm-hmm. Yes. All the wars of our world are caused by
It doesn't matter whichever religion you belong to. The fundamental value of teachings of every religion is to teach peace and harmony, loving kindness. That's how I strongly believe. The human-to-human connection, love and respect that connects human beings to each other, affection. That is what every religion is supposed to promote. But then misinterpretation of certain ignorant people creates an image of a different religion that is so negative. Yes. But whatever religion you belong to, most important thing is you are a human being who loves to be loved, who loves to be respected, who loves to be, you know, happy. That is our ultimate goal. A sense of meaning of your existence.
A sense of meaning?
Of your existence through which you are able to experience joy in your life. That joyfully you are able to live your life.
Joyfully. It is remarkable. I've learned a lot from you here in the studio, yes.
And I don't think I'm saying anything extra or anything new here. It's a universal truth. I think every being knows this.
Yes, and it's a living truth that you live.
Yeah.
This true, and this is not an intellectual knowledge.
Yeah. I'm not an intellectual being.
Yes, and it's a fortune for us that you are a very hard educated being. And in fact, yes, the heart, even in all tradition, the heart is the thirst place of looking, of searching and developing. Yes.
In fact, this is my first certificate of diploma, honorary diploma, which I'm very surprised with in my life. Never expected such thing.
We are honored to
that
Romania surprised you in this way. But it is a hard diploma, and it is the essence of your work, I think.
Thank you.
Allow me now to offer you also from Herald Publishing House, who is an important publishing house in Romania, who is publishing the only wisdom. And I'm sure that even though it is in Romania, you will accept as a Romanian sign for your work. It is the book, the Tibetan book of life and death. And it is beautiful, so Gyalo Rinpoche.
Yes, beautiful, a great teacher.
I think is a renowned
teacher.
This is
a very, very, very popular book around the world, not only in this one language, but I mean the teacher himself is a very, very highly respected and highly regarded master. in our tradition. And the book that he has written is, I heard, it's amazing. Mm-hmm. I mean, I haven't had a chance to read it myself, but mm-hmm. I mean, but I have heard a lot. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So this is really, really something I think is very, very beneficial for everyone to mm-hmm. be able to read mm-hmm. and to understand actually how to confront or be able to, it's very hard to say it actually, that the right word I'm, see, this is when I come to a point where I say my English is not as good as it mm-hmm. sounds. So mm-hmm. it's very, very good book for you, everyone to understand, to read it and mm-hmm. to be able to bring a more peaceful way of connecting to your mm-hmm. Existence mm-hmm. as well as non-existence of your physical body. I mean, you know, that usually people mm-hmm. are not so mm-hmm. happy to talk about death.
Yes, we are in the end of our interview mm-hmm. and Luca, our producer, kindly ask you if you accept to end our interview maybe with a prayer of a mantra or something.
Sure.
Thank
My
you.
Pleasure.
Thank you for being here. And
my pleasure. My pleasure.
Thank you.